So graph theory is an amazing field which has really developed a lot in the 20th century. And it has both very applied mathematics, very amazing application, like Google, for instance, but it also has amazing theoretical problems, which are very simple to state, but can be very, very hard to prove. And I'm going to mention one of them. Okay. So let's consider this map here. Once again, there's no geopolitical implication of what I'm about to say. I don't want to aggregate all of Europe together. It's just a representation of a map. So you have this map here and different countries. Now, the problem here is that we don't really see where the countries don't make the difference between the countries. And to do so, we need to color the countries. And one of the a big question that has been raised is what's the minimum number of colors that you need to color the map, the countries of this map, such that you can recognize the countries. And this boils down to coloring countries in different colors, coloring the countries with colors, such that two countries which are near each other, for instance, this one and this one, are colored with different colors. Okay? So if you take this map, you can try to color it, and you'll find out that with four colors, you can actually color this map. And it seems to be kind of a low. Like it seems like any map could actually be colored with four colors. And this has been conjectured in the 1850s, so quite a long time ago. And it was finally proven in the 1970s by Apple and Haken. But the proofs they use is not very satisfactory to mathematicians because it involves using a computer to check 1,400 particular cases. So they kind of broke down the big problem into 1,400 simpler cases. And they gave it to a computer, but because to give it to a human is very long for a human to check all these cases, and it's very boring. So they gave it to a computer, and at first nobody trusted the computer. You cannot check the computer, the proofs given by a computer. Now the trouble is, to this day, as far as I'm aware of, there's no simple proof of this. There's no proof for humans of this theorem, of this four-color theorem. And as far as I'm aware of, and that's also as far as Wikipedia is aware of. So if you don't trust me, trust Wikipedia. Well, there are actually proofs of this theorem. There are a lot of proofs of this theorem, but they are all mistaken. In fact, in the history of mathematics, I believe that this is the theorem which has the most mistaken proofs. In fact, there's even a book dedicated to all the mistaken proofs of the four-color theorem. That's how complicated this theorem is. And yet it looks so simple. Okay, let's assume that that the theorem is true and we can actually color the countries of this map with four colors. Does that mean that we can color the countries with four colors? Does anyone see the trick here? Well, this planet is round. It's not a map, so it's a round surface. And somehow coloring the countries of a planet, of a round surface, of a sphere, may be different from coloring a map. Well, the answer is no, it's not different. You still need four colors. The four-color theorem still holds for this planet. But that surprises me. I don't know if it surprises you guys. Doesn't seem to. Now, let me show you why it's surprising. Let's imagine we lived on this weird surface here. So here you have this weird surface. That's the sun in the middle. Let's assume we lived on this surface, and there were countries on this surface. Now, on this surface, the four-color theorem does not hold. You now need seven colors to color the countries of this surface. Now, are you surprised now? Well, still not. Again, now that's surprising because it doesn't seem like a sphere is very different from this shape here. So what makes the sphere very different from this shape? Well, it's a matter of connectivity, but it's another kind of connectivity, which is studied by topology. So let's go to South America. to study topology.